year is 1929. Wall Street just crashed, and the entire world was plunged into turmoil. The Great Depression produced panic, anxiety, and my mother, Angie McCartney. Born in Hoylake, near Liverpool, Angie describes these tough early years.
Times may have been hard, but what you never had, you never missed. I'd ride the overhead railway for a penny and look at the ships and dream of going to America.
During World War II, as a child, Angie spent her nights in the Anderson Air Raid Shelter waiting for the Luftwaffe to come. Shortly after the war, Angie spent time at Butlins in North Wales, where she met Bette Robbins, Jim McCartney's niece, when they both entered a beauty contest. Here's a picture of us on another trip to Butlins in about 1963. Hey! Who's that handsome man hiding in the bushes? And who knew my mum was going to wind up marrying him? This picture was taken at Rembrandt the morning after Jim and Ange were married. But being the end of November, it was way too nippy to be outside, so we all went into the lounge for a nice cup of tea. Paul would often make the drive up from London to Heswell to spend weekends out of the smoke and play with Martha the dog and me in the back garden. My dad loved a flutter on the horses, but little did he know what his next birthday present was about to be. And here's Dad with his beloved racehorse, Drake Strum. Must have been quite a job to gift wrap. Often Ange and Jim, aka Mum and Dad, would take the train down to London for nights out on the red carpet. Now here's a rare old collector's item, the coveted autographs of the Fab Four around the time they took off from Liverpool to conquer America. Today the dingle, tomorrow the world!